If you've been on the internet, like at all in the past 3 months since Vice President Harris announced that she was running for president, you've probably seen these memes, and you've probably seen a lot of them. Most importantly, you've seen how Kamala HQ, Harris's campaign's account, especially on TikTok, has been using these memes to appeal to a very specific, very online voter base, Gen Z, people like me. So I set out to see if this huge wave of memes and this TikTok meme campaign was actually working. I spoke to a lot of other Gen Z voters, interviewed a few who mostly felt that this kind of co-opting of these discourses that fandoms use, this kind of specific edit style, slide style format that TikTok is particularly conducive to, they mostly felt that it was kind of cringe.
Generally, as much as they thought it was smart campaigning strategy, they thought it was kind of cringy because it seemed to focus on using rhetoric that fandoms use for actual politicians that are meant to serve us, instead of actually engaging with the concerns that Gen Z has in terms of the ongoing genocide in Gaza, climate change, gun control, the cost of living right now in the US. The campaign seems to want to focus on this very curated image that is full of fan edit style images of Harris with Taylor Swift songs in the background or Chaperone's Feminine Phenomenon. And this, my piece argues, is the kind of concerning thing. This mixture of fandom and politics, when we really should be able to separate them.